a suitable opponent, whoever steps forward, with $10,000 if he can beat him. I'm anxious to see who that suitable opponent turns out to be. Killer Tim Brooks will be with us Monday night facing the young and exciting Steve Simpson. World-class newcomer Matt Bourne will be with us in an exciting bout. Be with us Monday night for all of this and more. Hope you're with us at 8 o'clock. The music begins to play as the smooth operator approaches the ring. I'm glad I'm not the ring announcer for this bout. It may start in a flurry. Here comes Bruiser Brody. First they Kringle in the ring with his golden tipped walking stick. TV title on the line. Let's go to stage.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match is your Beat the Television champion, Matt. It features one fall with a 15-minute time limit. Introducing first, from Mobile, Alabama, Percival Pringle III presents the world heavyweight champion whose belt is not on the line tonight, but also the world television champion whose belt will be on the line this evening, from Minnesota, ravishing Rick Rude. And his opponent this evening, weighing 300 pounds from Santa Fe, New Mexico, Bruiser Brody. Your official this evening, Mr. Rick Hazard.
All right, TV title bout here. $3,000 on the line as Percy Pringle looks things over, as does referee Rick Hazard. Gary Hart with $10,000 on the table for any wrestler who steps forward to get in the ring and perhaps beat this deadly Abdullah the Butcher, which I'm very leery of hearing about. Gary Hart has had quite a parade of dangerous, talented, and awesome people over the years. And what has he done now? Only time will tell. Here's the bell. Rude in his blue tights against Brody.
You keep that nut away from me.
Percy Pringle with instructions to the referee about keeping Bruiser Brody away from him. When you see our world title tape coming up from Texas Stadium later, you will see Percy Pringle get more than he bargained for from Brody. Coming up right after this bout, Bruiser Brody, Kevin, and Lance Von Erich will be out to talk with us. Rick Rude locks him up. Rude from the ropes holds on for dear life as Brody had that big foot top and ready. Percy backs away from an oncoming Bruiser Brody.
I don't trust him yet. I don't trust him at all.
Percy still complaining about Bruiser Brody as the bout continues. What a marvelous first-class job everybody with the new rodeo arena in Mesquite did when world-class championship wrestling came to Mesquite last Sunday. Our next big date for action in the beautiful new rodeo arena in Mesquite is Sunday, June the 22nd. We'll have details for you here on Channel 11. But boy, the parking situation, the directing of traffic, the arena itself, everything was first class as a tremendous crowd turned out last Sunday for the excitement. There's a big body slam by Bruiser Brody, and Rick Rude dives out to the floor. Thousands and thousands on hand in Mesquite yesterday, even bigger than anyone expected. Brody back in as Rick Rude continues to hurt.
You watch that maniac, Kevin!
Rude, the defending world heavyweight champion, defended it successfully thanks to a disqualification at Texas Stadium, about that you will get to see coming up later tonight. A referee stance, Bruiser Brody is locked up by the smooth operator. Can you believe what Gary Hart has told us tonight? Abdullah the Butcher here Monday night. You won't find me close by if possible. The big Memorial Day weekend, so bring everybody here as World Class celebrates with the annual Memorial Day Spectacular in Fort Worth. More on that card later. There's a kick. And Bruiser Brody goes down. There's an elbow by Root.
Now we're cooking with gas, brother.
A chop. Bruiser Brody back into the corner. Root with a drive. And this bout begins to heat up. Rick Root in charge right now. Brody fights back. Turns him around, lets him have it. Brody at work now. There's that big right foot raise. He doesn't need to jump. He just puts it straight up. Toe and a foot over the rope. Saves Rick Rude. I wish you could see the look on Percy Bringle's face. There it is. Complaining about a throat. I didn't see anything with a throat. Monday night, it's the world-class Memorial Day Spectacular in Fort Worth. A big six-man main event. Abdullah the Butcher against a suitable opponent. And much more. I'll run down the complete card later. All at the regular price. Parking is free. Be with us Monday, Memorial Day night. Bruiser Brody. To the floor as Rick Rude does well. You've got to give him credit. Rick Rude, the champion, right out, throws him into the steel post. Brody falling at the feet of the fans.
5 minutes, 5 minutes.
There's an elbow to the head. Brody throwing into another post. Percy parading around, ordering the fans around. There's an elbow by the smooth operator. There's a drop kick by Rick Rude, and Brody falls into the corner. Rick Rude has had the momentum here against one of the toughest opponents anyone could find anywhere. Bruiser Brody. Gary Hart tonight with the news of Abdullah the Butcher. Thank you. Rude pulls him off the ropes and continues to punish him. Brody in trouble. Rude climbing the ropes. He really caught him with a fist. Here's a pin, two, and Brody throws him off. Brody's not through yet. Rick Rude locking up Bruiser Brody. A toe-to-toe slugfest. Brody into the corner. Comes this way. Hits hard. Red charges. But Brody raises the foot. Brody kicks him into the corner. And Brody begins to show us some of what we expected. The only reason why we haven't seen it yet in this bout is because Rick Rude has done a great job of maintaining control. Brody down across the champion. One, two, this won't be enough. The world's best, Rick Rude, facing someone almost at his level, Bruiser Brody. A very different individual, but a very tough, tough man. Brody with a diving splash. Could be, might be, not quite through. High in the air, he takes him. And Brody stays on top. We're going to get a count. Percy Pringle's interfering. Swatting at Brody with the cane. There goes Bruiser after Percy. Rick Hazard out holding Brody away. Percy better be careful. Brody's after him. Percy heading up the aisle. Brody gives him a kick. And here they go. Here comes
house
the lights.
Lights, please. We need the house lights.
Here comes Brody back. Rick Rude is back on his feet in the ring.
Turn the house Brody lights down, please. We need the house lights turned down.
He's all over Rick Rude. Brody, hey, who is this? Did he come from the locker room or the crowd or what? What is happening here? Whoever it is gagging up. There goes Rick Hazard. Percy Pringle has gotten Rick Rude out of the ring to get the stairway. And this big man has down Bruiser Brody. It's Black Jack Mulligan. I'm reading the front of his shirt. Black Jack Mulligan is teaming up with Rick Rude. This must be the big news that Percy was talking about as he pounds that size 14 cowboy boot on the arm of Bruiser Brody.
We need help from the back. Wrestlers from the back, please. We need help from the back.
Dan Holmater calls for help from the back. A dangerous altercation has broken loose in the ring, the stairway to the ring. Pringle is talking about his dynasty as Black Jack Mulligan has arrived like a bolt from the blue. This huge man climbs the rope. Rude holds the arm, and it may be broken now. Holy cow, if you can hear me in the back of this building, hurry, we need help. Here comes Lance Von Erich. Lance Von Erich moves in on Rude. Mulligan does something to his arm and goes after Lance. Mulligan has some sort of claw on Lance Von Erich, and down he goes. Percy Pringle shoving Rick Hazard out of the way, interfering.
We need help from the back. We need help from the back.
Dan Hovater beckoning for more assistance. As Blackjack Mulligan being urged on by Percy Pringle with some sort of claw that has paralyzed Lance Von Erich. Bruiser Brody has a damaged arm. He's incapacitated in the ring. Here comes the grappler. That's not going to do any good, but Rick Rude kicks him out of the ring. Steve Simpson is in. Rude is on him. I haven't seen anything like this in a long time. Blackjack Mulligan on Brown it is. He's disposing of anybody that gets in his way. He and Rude throw Brian over the rope. Blackjack Mulligan back on to Lance Von Erich with that claw. Brody is totally incapacitated with the arm. Simpson, Adias, and the grappler have been disposed of. There goes the grappler again. They're out on the floor. The fans are standing in ringside. They finally gotten, thanks to Percy Pringle and other officials, Blackjack and Rude out of here. There's Lance Von Erich. Here comes Bronco Lubitsch and Ralph Foley. I don't know where they've been. Lance Von Erich's head is busted open. Look at it. His head has been torn open. Lance Von Erich bleeding down the face. Bruiser Brody may have a broken arm. I haven't seen damage like this since the tornado hit in Wichita Falls 3 years ago. My goodness, let's break. I'm going to see how bad this really is. Stay with us. We'll be back to talk to Brody, maybe Kevin and Lance on our scheduled interview.
Checking Bruiser Brody. We don't know anything yet. He's looking him over. Obviously, that arm is in a very painful state. I don't know to the extent of the injury yet, but we'll, of course, update you as our telecast progresses tonight. Lance Von Erich is also being looked at right now following that unexpected bolt from the blue attack from this Blackjack Mulligan that evidently Percy Pringle has gotten a hold of. Let's talk now about world-class action coming to Parker County as world-class action comes to Weatherford in the Parker County Sheriff's Posse's Rodeo Arena Thursday, May the 29th, with the matches starting at 8 o'clock. This exciting fundraiser card is sponsored by the Weatherford JCs, and on the card you'll be seeing Lance Von Erich, Gentleman Chris Adams, Brickhouse Brown, exciting Steve Simpson, Chief Mark Youngblood, the One Man Gang, the Great Kabuki, Hollywood John Tatum, Missy Hyatt, and many others. That's Weatherford Thursday, May the 29th in the Rodeo Arena at 8 o'clock, sponsored by the JCs. Of course, as I mentioned the name Lance Von Erich, everything's up in the air following what happened in the ring. I don't think Lance is hurt as bad as Brody. He just had his head split open. But like I say, I don't know anything yet. We'll just have to wait and see. Well, here comes Missy Hyatt and John Tatum.
Oh, you know, Mark,
good
you were in Texas
you,
Stadium. And you saw how I took Sunshine's hand, stuck it down in a mud.
Just like we said.
I put it down her shirt, put it down her pants. I even rode her around like she's a pig. Now, I found out that her weight advantage doesn't really matter once I get her down in the mud. I mean, we could have even put a tombstone on the mud and left her there. I mean, she looked awful. She wanted a pigsty match, and she got it. I got her good, didn't I, Hollywood?
It backfired on her, didn't it?
I know, it sure
well, now, she won the bout, but you are still offering any more mud matches that she wants, is that right?
Hey, if the referee wouldn't have been there, Mark, she'd probably be dead now.
I know, the referee, really, he got mad. And he interfered. And that's the only reason why she won. But I got her.
Hey,
I smashed her.
It kind of backfired on her, Mark Loren. Kind of back came as a surprise to her. But I got another surprise for you. I got another surprise for you, fat girl. And a surprise for Missy I hadn't let her in on yet. But I have taken it upon myself to sign
some more big star matches with Missy and Sunshine. What do you think about that?
Well, I'm all for it anyway.
What about that?
Can these happen anywhere?
Mark. Anywhere. It's a surprise to Missy. I haven't told her yet.
More pigs, really?
More pig. In the mud some more.
Put her head down
You're
going
to get to put her head down some
all
more.
All right, great.
You like that idea then?
Anywhere.
I love it.
Anywhere, any from Mother, Texas, Oklahoma, it doesn't matter, Mark. We're going to kill her. We're going to hold her down in the mud.
And I'm a rider again?
Just like you did
last
time.
And
Chris Adams. Chris Adams,
right.
I promise you, and I promise you, Missy, I will blind him permanently next time I get him in the ring. And I mean that, Mark Loren.
Well, that's a fine thing to be talking about, blinding somebody. That's Hollywood John Tatum and Missy Hyatt. Now, all evening long, I've been promoing Bruiser Brody and Lance and Kevin out here. Obviously, Lance and Brody can't be here. Kevin was parking his car during the altercation, was told what happened. He asked very sternly that his interview time be moved back so that he can see what's going on with Lance and Brody. Here now, Percy Pringle, have you got this guy under control?
This
I don't want to be involved.
He's under control, Mr. Mark Lawrence. You Texans wanted a cowboy. I brought you a cowboy. You want a world champion? Here's a world champion. The Pringle Dynasty, brother. The games are over with. It's time to get down to the brass tacks. The war has begun today. Tell him, Ricky.
That's right, Lawrence. You know, I got together with Percy Pringle to figure out what was going on here in this stupid state. Seemed like the odds were stacked against us a little bit. Can you understand what I'm saying, Mark Lawrence?
Yes.
Yes. I'm talking about some Von Erichs, Bruiser Brody, the whole clan. You see, I'm the world champion, but I want a whole lot more than that. I want to own the whole damn country. And Percy and I put our heads together, and we got just about the biggest, baddest dude in the world right here on our side. Black Jack Mulligan, good to see you again, Jack. I want everybody here to stop everything they're doing for a minute. Go and get your old lady, your fat old lady, from the kitchen. Set her down in front of the TV set. Get them ugly kids, the curtain climbers, around the TV set. Throw them in the back of that pickup truck, that raggedy pickup truck that you call a Ford truck, and listen to what I got to say. Because there was a time in the sport of wrestling when there was only two meanest men in the world. One was Black Jack Mulligan, the other was Bruiser Brody, and now that's been taken care of. Bruiser Brody is going to be nursing himself in the hospital. Listen to me, pay attention to me. For about the next 6 to 8 weeks. All my life, I have lived for the return to my homeland. It was said that I was run from my home by Fritz Von Erich. It was a young kid by the name of Mulligan that defeated you for the U.S. title, Fritz. I don't know how you lost it. Whether you just don't want to fight no more, whether you're just too wealthy, you have to sit there and take it. But don't send a young kid to do a man's job. Because Mulligan is back under the guidance of Percy Pringle, standing here with the world heavyweight champion. And I will never leave this town. I will never leave this state. I will never leave this alliance. Unless it's on a stretcher. Von Erich, Brody, Mulligan has returned to claim what is rightfully his, heir apparent to the master of the claw.
You like cowboys? I brought you a cowboy.
Well, I don't know what to say the way things have gone around here tonight. I don't really want to say anything other than Black Jack Mulligan is an awfully big guy and evidently has something in that hand that is pretty powerful when it comes time to using a claw. I'm going to go back and check in on the situation in the back. And when we come back, perhaps I'll have an update and bring you our TV main event as well. We'll be back. Tonight here at Will Rogers Coliseum at 8 o'clock is World Class Championship Wrestling. celebrates Memorial Day with the annual Fort Worth Memorial Day Spectacular here at Will Rogers Coliseum, 8 o'clock. Parking is always free. The ticket prices are the same for this big card, which features an exciting six-man main event, the one-man gang, the Great Kabuki, and Ravishing Rick Rude, against Kevin, Lance, and Bruiser Brody. Problem is now, Bruiser Brody definitely cannot wrestle Monday, so there is a void there, and we'll have to see who will take the place. Black Jack Mulligan will be appearing on this big Memorial Day card against Brian Adias. What a test for Brian. Killer Tim Brooks has an exciting date with Steve Simpson. I've talked about the excitement in that matchup, the two contrasting individuals. Exciting Matt Bourne will be on hand to face Brickhouse Brown, and Abdullah the Butcher will be on the card facing a suitable opponent. $10,000 if the opponent can win. That's Abdullah the Butcher and much more Monday night, Memorial Day night, here in Fort Worth. We've heard from Missy Hyatt. Let's hear from Sunshine.
This is May, right?
Yes.
This is May? That's funny because it felt like December all day today. I got a call this morning from the promotion, and they said there was all kinds of contracts, signed contracts, waiting for me at the office for mud matches. Missy, you're such a dingbat. If I were you, I'd have somebody other than Hollywood do my business for me, because he might as well sign you up for the death penalty, sweetheart. This time, I'm not going to be satisfied from seeing, just to see you covered in mud. I'm not going to be satisfied to pin you 1, 2, 3. This time, I'm going to stick mud so far down your throat, you're going to have to dig it out with a shovel, Missy Hyatt. And I've got another surprise, because the gentleman is back. Yes, ma'am, Chris Adams. This Friday night, he's going to tag team with the Missing Link against your little puppy dog, John Tatum, and that maniac, the Great Kabuki. And after what you did last week at the Sportatorium, this time I'm going to get my little chair, and I'm going to set it right next to yours. Now, I've already promised a promotion that I'm not going to lay a hand on you. But if you pull a move like you did last time, if you even think about it, you're going to be mine all night long. Do you remember I'm going to make you choke on your words, Missy Hyatt? It's over for you. Mud, you haven't seen mud yet.
The words of Sunshine, excitement about Missy Hyatt. I mentioned the six-man Monday. Brody can't rust. We have a void there. Lance Von Erich has been bandaged up. He's going to be all right, and he will be with us Monday. Skip Young, glad to have you with us, sir. You rode with Kevin tonight. Great. You were just a little late.
Broken arms. One guy split open. Kevin and I just drove in. We couldn't even get in for the paramedic. But I want to take the time out to thank World Class Championship Wrestling for giving me the opportunity to come out here in front of my fans and friends to show you that I'm still live and living color. And I'm as strong as a prayer, and I'm looking forward to wrestling here again one day, so y'all pray for me.
Thank you, Skip. Glad to have you with us tonight. Now, here's running mate Kevin Von Erich tonight. Kevin, I'll shake your hand as well. Boy, what an unpleasant thing we had happen tonight.
I come in, they've got Lance stretched out, throwing his head up. They've got Bruiser Brody with an inflatable splint on his hand. What's going on here? I hear they've got Abdullah the Butcher coming in. Black Jack Mulligan, I heard talk. I thought it was just talk. Let me just give a little message here. I am not afraid of Black Jack Mulligan. I know all about him. Yeah, he's big and scary, but I learned from the master of the Iron Claw. I learned from the master of the Iron Claw. I'm not afraid of Black Jack Mulligan.
Kevin, let's talk a little bit about the six-man bout Monday. We already know Bruiser Brody can't wrestle. There's going to be a void there. Someone's going to have to step in. It's a big Memorial Day card and a big six-man bout.
I heard the word fracture back there. That I guess Bruiser Brody's not going to be wrestling. I was with Lance mainly. It's really hectic back there. Don't worry about it. It's a big match with Rick Rude, one-man gang, Kabuki. Lance has had, you know, stitches or something an athlete can contend with. If it has to be just Lance and me, we'll be all right. We'll take this match. Things are kind of crazy right now, but they'll be fine. I just wish I'd been here a little earlier.
Well, I wish you had, too. Of course, we had the interview time schedule. Kevin Ashley wanted to take care of Lance and see what the deal was on Brody and ask for this time to come out. Anything else, Kevin?
Well, Kerry's in Japan. Kerry won't be back till later. And that's just it. Don't worry about Lance. He's split open. He's scary thought, but he's going to be all right. He'll be here next Monday, I guarantee it.
All right, Kevin, here's Chris Adams now.
Kev, excuse me. I'm sorry to interrupt your interview. I didn't mean it. Listen, there's just something I'd like to say. I'd like your permission, please. So I can say it.
Go ahead.
Okay. I know that I've been wrong. I know that I've been very, very wrong. Okay? And all you people know that I've been wrong. But I found out something last week that I wasn't meant to know. And because of that, I would like to make you an offer. And I know that next Monday, you're looking for another partner for the six-man tag team. And I'm asking you for a second chance. Please, will you let me be your partner and Lance's partner in the six-man deal?
An invitation.
Chris, I've been watching you for a long time. Now, just for the record, this isn't the second chance you're talking about. You're talking about the third chance. The second chance was when you sent me to the hospital with stitches in the back of my head with intent to injure me for good. I've been watching you, and you do look like you've made a turnaround. Let me tell you this. Lance and I would take these men on 2-3 if we had to.
I know.
I'm no fool, Chris.
This is Kip. I know you're no fool. I know you're not stupid. I know you've been watching me. I know, above all, that I'm wrong. And I'm asking you for another chance. Please, let me be your tag team partner. I'll watch your back. I'll watch Lance's back like you've never been watched before. And that's my promise to you. You can't say that I never mean what I say. I always mean what I say.
I've got to go check on Lance, but Chris, you've got your shot. Next Monday, you just show up. We'll see then. Bye, Mark. I've got to go take care of Lance.
Thank you, Kev. Chris, anything else?
Mark, I want you to know, and I want the people at home to know, that I never say anything unless I mean it. And I've always mentioned this in my interviews. And when I say that I will be a Von Erich partner, I mean that I will be a Von Erich partner. I aim to have the Von Erichs and Chris Adams just like they used to be, victorious. And I really mean it, Mark, from the bottom of my heart.
That's good news, Chris. Best of luck to you, sir. Chris Adams, obviously a changed man. We all know the tragic end of the dynamic duel and what's happened. Chris Adams, a sharp character, has reflected on things, and I think the future is certainly bright. There's a match for Monday. I'll check that and let you know if it's signed. I'm sure it will be. And we'll be back. I'll let you know on that and have our world title tape in a moment. Signed, sealed, and delivered, Chris Adams, the addition to that exciting Memorial Day six-man main event Monday night here in Fort Worth. Now, let's take a quick look at Dallas. We're running low on time tonight. Ravishing Rick Rude in the main event Friday night at the Sportatorium against Lance Von Erich. Hollywood John Tatum and the Great Kabuki are in a tag team main against the Missing Link and Gentleman Chris Adams. Black Jack Mulligan, look out. We'll face Brickhouse Brown on the card. Matt Bourne against Jerry Allen. Other names include Steve Simpson and Brian Adias. A big night Friday night in Dallas. I don't mean to be quick, but we're running low on time. A first-class card. Look forward to seeing you there. World Heavyweight Championship now. Your championship sports...